Let's give Jesus a praise in the house. Brethren, the problem with many of us is this. We are too extreme that the devil has been defeated. And the other end is, oh, everything is devil. Even if you see cockroach, very early in the morning indication, you can call your pastor. Because it's that which is a wizard in your village. Please, if that is how they kill, no one will be on this side. Are you here with me? Because they boss in the name of Jesus. Some people now, if you say Nigeria, don't go there, they will kill you. Many people go back and forth. My brother here, stand up. Are you not? If I tell you this one is from Nigeria, can you believe? He's faster than many of you. May God bless you, sir. See that? When he told me he's from Nigeria, I said, you cannot be sure. I told him, I said, you don't look like Nigeria. See, robust, fine, people are still living good there. Praise the Lord, somebody. Yeah. I always tell the witches and wizards in my village that I'm coming. They know the day I'm coming now. I tell them, I announce it. I don't go to my village on announce. I will kill cow for them, they will eat. Many of them will give their life. Not me, you wait there, right? I will announce I'm coming. You must not fly, or else I lose you. Because greater is he that is in me. Praise the Lord, somebody. If you fly, we'll crash you down. Give no place to the devil. I don't celebrate them. Listen carefully here. The problem, number one, is the misidentification of this enemy. Many of us don't identify him because he's a remarketing agent. He's a professional marketer. It takes discernment to identify this man, enemy. Because he has been from beginning, so he knows everything. He knows everything, he has preview of what is to happen. And he knows what we want, and he knows how to get it. And that is why today, after today's teaching, I will take my time. If he comes around, you just knock his head. You have no place here. Get up here. May God help us in the name of Jesus. Many of us cannot identify him. Because he's full of these guys. He's full of these guys. And that is where I'm starting from today. I want you to know that it's not as ugly as you think. If I should show you in the scripture, this Satan is so beautiful, he's so good looking, he's so handsome, that if God is not taken until you have the Spirit of God, you will even be attracted from nowhere. He can talk so good, he can talk so well, he can even give whatever you want, but because he has a purpose. If you go to Ezekiel 28, verse 12 to 19. Because if I should ask many of you to describe him now, you will say he has horn in his head, he has goblet in his hand. He has nothing like that. He said, son of man, take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyros. And said unto him, thus said the Lord, you can give me an NIV because of my people. Give me an NIV for super understanding. I want to teach in this way. King of Tyre, and said to him, this is what the sovereign Lord said. You are the seal of the perfection, full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. Referring to him, you are in Eden. He started from the Garden of Eden. The Garden of God. Every precious stone adorned you. Chalcedonians, chrysolites, and emeralds, topaz, onyx, jasper, lapis, lazuli, turquoise, and beryl. Your setting on the mountains were made of gold. On the day you were created, they were prepared. Let's go. You were anointed as a guardian cherub. For so I ordain you. But you are on the holy mount of God. You walk among the fairy stones. Let's go. You are blameless in your way from the day you were created till wickedness was found in him. He was made a beautiful creature from the beginning. And he didn't lose that beautiful creature apart from his relationship with God when God casted him down. You can read it up to 19 because of time. I don't need to go there. Because you go to Revelation 12:10, you will find out that he said that dragon, the ancient serpent, the accuser of brethren, has been casted down. Revelation 12:10. Listen very carefully. I'm going somewhere with you today. Is it 10:12 or 12:10? 10:12. He said, For the accuser of our brother and sister who accuses them before our God has been what? Casted down. I just want to tell you, many a times it comes so beautifully. Bible says in Genesis 3:1, he says Satan was very subtle of all the animals. It was the one, serpent was the one that Eve loved most. You can't love something that is not good. It's comely, quiet, cool, gentle. Praise the Lord, somebody. So many a time we misidentify him. And the problem with this is, if you misidentify your enemy, what will happen? You make your friend your enemy, and you make your enemy your friend. So what prayer you pray? May you not make your enemy your friend.
Amen.
And may you not make your friend your enemy.
Amen.
You know, when you make your friend, they're supposed to bless your enemy. Can you imagine confusion? And that's why many people, when they want to marry, because a guy can talk so quietly, and my dad is the one that owns Bristol, and whatever, and this and that and that. And the quiet boy who was still struggling with one shoe, that God has sent an update to his life, like this one, I look at him. At the end of the day, he will find out to become the champion. And that other one will only be in your life for one. Listen, God will expose Satan.
Amen.
In every form, God will expose Satan.
Amen.
Are you ready for this teaching?
Yes.
May God help us in the name of Jesus. Amen. Tell somebody once more, beware of the scheme of the evil one. Tell somebody, beware of the logic of the devil. Tell somebody, beware of the tactics of this ugly devil. In the name of Jesus. So, brethren, I want to tell you, he has no truth in him at all. Devil has no truth. But he always wants to present himself as the truth. He has no light. But he always wants to present himself as light. Brethren, he can operate in the life of believers and non-believers. Don't think because you are a believer that he can't do you anything. And don't think because he's a non-believer and he won't go there. If you go to Matthew 24:24, that scripture says a time is coming that fake Messiah, fake Christ will come, fake prophet will come, and they will present themselves. They will do signs, they will do miracles, they will do wonders, they will speak in tongues, they will do so many things. But Bible says, be careful because they can lead you astray. Even what? The elect. Who are the elect? The sanctified one, the born again ones. And if you go to 2 Corinthians 4:4, he said, when the God of this world, the ruler of this age, because when he was casted from heaven, he was casted there on earth, he's the ruler of this world here. Are you here with me? When he comes, he blinds the mind of those that does not believe. So he works by blinding the mind of the unbeliever so they cannot see the light of the glory of God. Are you here? He gives them in perpetual darkness. And he will now lead those that believe away from the truth. So therefore, brethren, I want to tell you today that he has no power. He has been defeated. All he's using is deception. And he either keeps someone in darkness, lead someone away from the way of truth, or blind their mind to the truth. And that is why you should be careful. Anyone that doesn't want you to come to the house of God, anyone that is discouraging you from taking your seat in the place of God, anyone that is disturbing you from worshiping God, anyone that disturbs you from coming to a place where the true word of God is being shared, that person is not your best friend. Or my son, who tried to block you from listening or hearing what? The truth. We are going forward. Therefore, brethren, this man has no truth. From the beginning, in the Garden of Eden, he has been with human beings. And what he's looking for is he's looking for people in his own kingdom. Because his kingdom is against the kingdom of God. And the assignment, put it down, every trick of devil, every operation of devil, every logic of devil, everything that devil introduces to us, we lead ultimately into destruction and death. John 10:10. Christ comes to give us life so we have life abundantly. But he has come to do what? To keep, to steal, and to what? Look at it this way. Whenever a promise is made for a child of God, he wants to stand against that promise. And that is why anytime you make a public declaration of something before people and before God, that is when you should start praying. Because the moment you make that utterance, the moment he wants to stand against it. Now, I'm taking you somewhere. There is no truth in him. Go to John chapter 8, verse 44. John 8, 44. He said, you belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out your father's desire. Listen, every desire of the devil is for you to do something against the will of God. Put it down. Every desire of the devil is for you to do something contrary to what God ordered. For you to do something that will provoke God to anger. To do something that will not make you have a right standing before God. Every desire of devil will lead to fall, destruction, and death. He was a murderer. You see, he murdered destiny. He murdered marriages. He murdered businesses. He murdered faith. From the beginning, right from the Garden of Eden. Not only what? To the truth. There is no truth in him. There is no truth in him. He lies. When he speaks what?
Lie.
Because he has been a liar from the beginning. I'm taking you somewhere now. And that is why Jesus Christ came in 1 John chapter 3 verse 8 to destroy his work. That scripture says, whosoever that sin, that is sinning is of the devil. For the devil has been sinning from the beginning. And that is why Jesus Christ to do what? To destroy his work. Put it out, every work of devil is to work against the promise of God in our life. I'm taking you something like that. How does he operate? I've established to you that he uses deception. I've established to you that he's not all that powerful. But he can still influence. Look at it this way, I shared it at the beginning. Good people, we automatically align with good people. But for a good person to align with bad, there must be a degree of influence from the bad. Bible says, deep color, deep iron, sharpened iron. Are you listening to me? Like he said, lion don't give out to dwarf. So therefore, he uses his trick to influence and impact us in his way. So how does he do this? Go to Genesis 3. Let's do a case study from there. I'm not in a hurry to teach this. Because this year of perfection, we will enjoy God.
Amen.
God will expose him in our marriage. He will expose him in our business. He will expose him in our church. Amen. So when he's coming with his ugly, I'm just saying, come on, get out there. We have more time to pray about him. Because he's under our feet already. Shout the big hallelujah. Now the serpent was more crafty. You see, he doesn't have a gun in his head. He was so cunning than any of the wild animal that Lord God has made. He said to the woman, did God really say you must not eat from the tree in the garden? You see, he's not all-knowing, put it down. If he's all-knowing, he wouldn't have asked this question. And that's why they say, maybe you're on his side. He's looking at me too much. It's the devil, he won't see it. Hello? He's not all-knowing. Oftentimes, he uses what he gets from us to afflict us. And the woman too, who had diarrhea of mouth, started talking. You see, there are folks who are working for them, who will use dead word to get life word from you. They will tell you, they know they have foreclosed your house, so they want to know your financial status. When am I coming to come and eat dinner in that your house? They knew already. That my house. My husband cheated me. They fired me from my job. I couldn't pay mortgage. You now started saying all the story of your life. For those of you that are talking too much, I want you, don't kill your destiny for yourself. Many of you talk too much. Especially if you are a man, you talk too much. We need to seal your mouth with Holy Spirit and give you Holy Communion. Talk all the time. Listen, when you talk all the time, what time do you have to sit down and reflect on what God is about to do in your life? People that talk too much eventually will lie and they ruin their destiny. And he started talking, put it down. Never have any dialogue with Satan. Put it down.
Never have any dialogue. He operates by engaging us in a dialogue. Are you here with me? In James 4:7, he says, submit unto God. Resist the devil. If you submit unto God, you won't have dialogue with the devil. Because 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 22, he said, flee from all appearances of devil. Don't enter into any dialogue. Point number one. So as he enters into the dialogue, look at the next thing. Let's go. You see, reject. Tell somebody, reject every kind of evil. Reject every. It's not that evil. Every kind. Do I need to explain to you every kind of evil? Appearance of evil. Something. You see, evil always have representation. He operates by a demon. Oh my God. I'm not teaching you demonology, but he operates with demon. Demon of lying, demon of gossip, demon of fornication, demon of adultery, demon of unforgiveness, demon of fire, demon of strife. You see? And he will not work with you with what you are not interested in. If you know you love money, bring demon of money and throw it into you. If you know you can drink too much, you drop demon of drunkenness into the house and he will walk away. So listen very carefully. Flee from anything that appears like what?
Evil.
Flee from it. If you are somewhere and you are doing credit card Bible says flee from every appearance of what?
Okay.
Oh, you are there. They are watching Google nude picture. Don't say God said you should give all hands to wash and be washed. Don't say God said you should flee from every appearance of evil. May God help us. There was a man of God that came from Nigeria here. When he saw the way things are going on, he returned himself to Nigeria. He said, I don't want to go to hell. Praise the Lord, somebody. I know my God, time has gone. May God help us. Now, listen very carefully. Go to that discussion. He entered into dialogue with that woman. And he said, no, that one gave him the specification. I've told you, don't dialogue with devil. Dialogue, discussion of devil can come in many ways. If you are a man, a woman always come to you. I remember in this church, one woman always come to me all the time. Hey, my husband is not having sex with me. It's not this, it's not that. It's not. I said, okay, you know, at this point, let me handle your husband. Let my wife help you. Bible says, flee from what? Yes. If your husband don't touch you for 2-3 years, what are you showing into my life? That's a seed. A week after then she left the church. That's why it's not every time you see people leaving church, you think that the church is not good. Some people want must leave. But the good want to stay. That's the area we are going to now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. So he made that to the woman. He said, you will not die. What does he do? He made God a liar. Put it down. He always wants to put God as a liar before you. And he himself is the real liar. Himself is what? He's the real liar. And that is why you have to be careful of the way people are dressing things for you to present it. You be careful. You have to have spirit of discernment. He said you will start telling on that. So, what did he do? He said now you will not die. He said the day you eat it, your eye will open. Put it down. He always wants us to not believe God. He wants to feel that God is a liar so that you cannot believe his promises, so that you will doubt his promises of provision, you will doubt his promise of healing, you will doubt his promise of protection. That's why I will tell you, you think all this Bible will help you? Oh, you better let me take you to a Baba that will give you something that you will tie, and anywhere you go to, if they want to fight you, it's like that Baba said, he's suffering from tuberculosis in the house. You see, the way when I saw the secret of these people, oh my God, I won't rush this teaching because I've used my practical life experience to teach you in this teaching. When I was in the Kirun, my wife knew, that's why I know this woman, she's a strong woman. When I was doing my internship at General Hospital Oshogbo, the year Dini of the Kirun, she got shot God of Shikipos, that's what she worshiped. And she got that village in Imuleke. Imuleke, very near Okuku. I'm telling you life story. She took us there. That thing only come out once in a year. Once in a year. I would look at it. I said, God, my wife came from there. When I was living with her, she came, she gathered all my clothes. She burned it to the face of the woman. It's my wife. So you can live here. Are you listening to me here? Where am I going there? They will always present to you that God cannot save you. And they will take you to a better, another deeper place where your destiny will be tied wrongly. It will put it down this way. It will make God a liar to you. It will over-exaggerate the player of sin. Put it down. And undermine the consequence of sinning. That's his logic. Over-exaggerate. Don't worry. Go and steal the money. They won't see you. He will make it big. You see, your friend that buy cars, your friend that building houses. Why can't you try? Do they have children? This your church shall be going all this time. See your pastor. He's changing his. Your pastor is wrong. I'm not using your friend. But we want your attention to it. Don't you see his tag? Let me tell you the story why I love suits today. I told my wife. You see, when you see people doing things, you don't. When I was doing my graduation, I couldn't go and tell my dad because of the prophecy that came. I was the only one that graduated. I have used a borrowed suit with my friend. Because I couldn't tell my dad. I had to borrow my friend's suit for my graduation. And I won so many prizes in the school that day.
Oh my God.
But I was the only one that entered into graduation on my own, and my God. And I make up my mind, I shook my head, I said, when God bless me, suit will be like anything in my house. So don't let them say your pastor is wearing suit. I made a covenant to God. When you are not yet, God may not come. I'm just telling you, those are the way it deceives you. You see, pastor, I walk over time, I walk hard. Because I know the expressions I'm doing. Don't just stand there and say, when the man of you are still sleeping, I'm already in my work. I'm telling you the Holy Ghost. Are you listening to me? Yes. But we use all those things to do what? To deceive you. Over-exaggerate the player of sin, undermine the consequence of sinning. Eventually, he said they will not die. But the truth of the matter is they did not die physically, but they died spiritually. Sure. Do you know thorn and stone? Thorn was not in the creation. Until when God caused them out of the land, thorns begin to grow. Wasn't part of thorns and tissue was not part of creation. It was after casting them out. That symbolizes pain and struggle. Don't ever go into dialogue with Satan. Don't ever go into dialogue. So, brethren, how does it happen? Go to Job again. Go to Job chapter 1, Greek verse 7 there. He was a Roman. He said, the Lord said, Satan, where have you come from? He said, I am going, roaming about to and fro. Put it down this way. He's always restless. He goes about to and fro. But he has a target. He has a vision. He has a goal. He's not just roaming aimlessly. He's roaming aimfully. Go to 1 Peter 5:8. He said, your adversary, be sober and vigilant, for your adversary, Satan, is like a running lion, looking for whom. So when he's going to and fro, he's looking for whom to devour. If you get to this door and knock the door here, you don't open for him, you go to your neighbor. If you don't open, you go to the next neighbor. If you don't open, he's coming back again. That's how he's going. But he's looking for whom to devour. Put it down. He's restless but aimful. And now, I'm taking you somewhere, he will never operate when you don't give him a place. As he's roaming about, we continue to roam about. But the moment you give him a place, trust me, it will operate. Ephesians 4:26. He said, in your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry. Verse 27. Lest you give Satan a foothold. That is, change it to New Living Translation. Give Satan a chance. Give Satan an opportunity. Give Satan a place. Tell somebody, don't give Satan a place in your home. Don't give Satan a place in your marriage. Don't give Satan a place in your ministry. Don't give Satan a place in your job. Because without you giving him a place or opportunity, he cannot do anything. So he's looking to and fro. Are you here with me? Looking for somebody that will give him a place. Look here, look at me. The moment he has a place in your life, in your marriage, in your home, even if you don't want to open, he will tell you, I have the legal right to be here. You have your fridge full of anything. And you knock the door. Say, Satan, you don't have the door here. I have my property in your fridge, open it. It's in the level 2 there. That green bottle there. And the man will just drink it. After some time, just look at the man. I say, he tell me, he told what you have drank is enough. Listen, you can't be controlling me. I can have been drinking before your mom. You see my mommy that you mentioned like that? Your own mommy too, before you know it. Because he has property there. If you are watching pornography, are you listening to me? You are watching pornography, you have pornography in your house. You are giving a place to what? Either you wash it with the husband. If you are a man here, you have that dirty thing on your phone. Tell devil, I don't give you any place. Or a woman is sending you a nude picture. And you are talking of a witches and wizard in the village. No, that witches and wizard is on your phone. You are carrying it here. May God help us. Because there is no way you will look at all those things and you watch all those things and you will not caught up with the spirit. When you see all these people that are under homicide investigation, the first thing they look into is to their computer and their TV to see the kind of movie they are watching. And most of them, you will see all these dragons. That's why I don't want this kid to go and watch all this dragon movie, whatever. Because they are spirit behind those things. I know what I'm saying. Now, if you go to Job 1:7, he now said, do you think, wait, he said, do you think Job fear you for nothing? That this, he was trying to accuse Job, that the faithfulness of Job to God is not real. It's because of what God has done. So see the way, if we misrepresent God to us, so that we can doubt the promises of God, so we can be looking for alternative God, and God has no alternative, so it can be because of that passion. And if we now go and accuse us before God, that pastor, is he a pastor? He's not a pastor, no. He yelled yesterday, he yelled last week. Who has not yelled here? He talked to your hand. Yeah? I don't mind him. 7 years ago, sir, I remember, you know that guy, 15 years ago, when he went to party. That's why. And Jesus will now say, come. That's why I went to the cross. That's what I want to do. He always wants to accuse you. And that's why when you see people that accuse you unnecessarily, devil is already working in him or her. It's now left for you to back up and just find somewhere to go. Because if you respond to that devil, it must be. So he's an accuser. From beginning, he wants to accuse you. If he can cause you to accuse your wife that you are cheating on me, even when the poor woman is praying for you, he will make you believe that he's cheating on you and he'll be accusing you. He didn't put good salt. He was talking too much on the phone when she was cooking. That's why he will accuse you. And God said, who can accuse? Who can put a child against the elect? He said, no one. It's the Lord that justifies. Brethren, he premises himself God and he accused us before God. And let me tell you, children of God, if not for Jesus on the throne, sitting on the right hand side of God, devil has every ground to accuse you. Because we keep doing things daily that will make him have a legal ground against us. But thank God for that blood. Thank God for Jesus that sat there on that throne advocating for you and myself.
Hallelujah.
Now, how does he do this? Put it, he can fill your heart with his wrong thought. Put it down. Acts chapter 5, verse 3. Ananias and Sapphira. The land belonged to them. Is that not their land?
Yeah.
Eh? Is that not their land? They can say that and say, okay, listen carefully. We are not going to give you 100%. We have challenges in our family. We are only giving you 20% or 10%. Are you here with me? And God will say, that is okay. But he put it in their mind. Because Peter said, Ananias, how is Satan has so filled your heart? Put it this up. One of the wise is, I fill our heart with his wrong thought. He said that, don't worry. Show them. Are you here? Show them. That's all. But keep half of it. They won't know. Many of you are looking at me. After all, we are not selling that.
You do that many times. You do that many times.
Let me tell you, somebody that sealed an envelope in the church, he didn't put any money there. Just because he just wants to walk out with people that are walking out. And he just drop empty envelope and put it in the offering. What about that?
Satan filled his heart.
You that you don't have money. You don't have money. You are still struggling. And you are making people feel that I can take care of all of you. When you cannot even take care of yourself enough.
Satan make it feel. That's the way it works. That's Satan. Feel it in the heart.
Are you listening to me? Satan can feel somebody's heart to steal from somebody that they won't know, don't worry. Anytime you see any wrong thoughts, babbling, crisscrossing, don't worry. Go and sleep with that girl. They won't know. No worry. After all, you are friends together. Don't worry, they won't find out. After all, you are starting.
That's devil's thoughts. May God help us in the name of Jesus.
How does he operate again? Apart from filling our hearts. Look at Judas Iscariot. Bible says he was doing good until Satan does what? Fill his hearts. Anytime you are doing something good and all of a sudden you start doing something bad, check yourself. How does he do it again? Number one, he can use people to lead us astray because of time. I'll continue from there. He can use people to do what?
To lead us astray.
Are you listening to me? That was one of the reasons why God still kept his covenant upon Jacob, why we read today. Because Jacob really said, I walk up with my father. She know. Rebecca said, your father will not know. Even if your father know, I will take the curse. And the curse was upon her. Because since that guy left, she didn't see that guy till she died. People can lead us astray. That's why we beware of people that can lead us astray. That's why I show you Matthew 24:24. And listen very carefully. In the church of God, if you look at the story of Eve, he placed on Eve emotion and mood. How do I say this? Can I conclude this? Eve must have been looking at that fruit. It's beautiful to behold in the heart. Listen, you can't just go and sleep with a woman you have not been seen. You cannot just go take a man to the hotel that you have not been seen. There's something you have been looking. You can't just steal a money that you have not planned to spend it for something. Are you looking at me here today? This is what I'm teaching here. He played on that mood and that emotion. And he told her what she wanted to hear. You will not die. If you are always comfortable to hear what you want to hear, check yourself here this morning. This is the first Sunday of the seventh year. If you are doing bad thing and all you are looking for to hear is someone that will say that bad thing is right, is a lie. That's devil representative. And he warned us in the church that we should beware of people that will not teach you the sound doctrine. Because he said towards the end, some people will depart from faith, just like devil beguiles Eve and lure them away from the path of righteousness. Anyone that asks you that you are stealing is right. Anyone that asks you that you are fornicating is right. Anyone that tells you you are gossiping is right. Anyone that tells you that having pride is right is luring you away from the truth. Devil is using that person to lure you. Give me Galatians 5, read verse 18 to 20. If any one of us have all these practices, but if you are led by the Spirit of God, you are not under the law. Go to 19. The act of the flesh, because the desire of the devil is for us to fulfill the flesh. Sexual immorality, so, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fit of rage, self-ambition, dissension, faction, you see? And envy, drunkenness, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the world. So if there is anyone saying that is a man of God and is encouraging any of these things, just know that person is trying to lead you what? Astray. It's as simple as ABC. I can't teach it more than this. I don't need to be hot to teach this. It's a simple teaching. May God help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Brethren, there is a king in the scripture. A prophet in the scripture. That prophet, God told that prophet everything that will happen. He's a small prophet. He said Josiah will be the rain at the other hill. He prophesied to Jeroboam that the altar will be split and forever. And Jeroboam was so surprised, and the old prophet knew what that guy said. He now came, he said, I am an old prophet. God said, you shouldn't eat and you should go out of the city by another way. But he decided to go and convince them and say, listen, nothing will happen to you. Go and eat. And the small prophet, because he said he's an old prophet. Listen, you can be born again yesterday.
and still know the right thing, but as somebody has said, he has been born again 27,000 years. It's not the year you're born again, it's the truth that you hold on to and you do. That's why I'm standing up asking Bible questions. Doesn't mean that when the truth comes, you know it. We are going to teach here this year. Let's give Jesus a praise. Yeah. Yeah. You know that guy went and eat. And as he was eating, the same prophet said, because you have disobeyed God, God said, he will show you. And as he was doing, lion came from nowhere, devoured and came. Why do you think he ate that food? Because that one came in the name of old prophet. Many will deceive the elect. That's why you should hold on to the truth. And may God help us in the name of Jesus. Amen. I ran out this teaching today. I continue from there. Next week. That don't give devil a place. Don't dialogue with him. Don't give him a place. Unforgiveness. He said, if there's somebody you have to forgive, forgive the person, or else Satan will outwit you. If you don't give him a place, he cannot operate. It's not powerful. His power is in deception, tricks. And that's why you have to guard yourself with the truth. Let anybody comes in the name of speaking in tongue, in the name of prophecy. Don't just stress yourself. Go carry the Bible. Whatever he or she tells you, open the Bible. If he says it's the Spirit of God, the Spirit will not contradict the word. Because the Bible says no prophecy has its own interpretation. Men of God move as God has given utterances. And behind every written word of God, there is the inspiration of the living God. Are you listening to me? The Bible says there is a spirit in man, the breath of God giving understanding. In this Bible is the spirit of the living God. The Bible says the beginning was the word and the word was with God. And nothing was made that was made without the word. And the word manifested himself in flesh. That's what we call the Son of God. So anything anybody tells you, go and line it up here. If it doesn't work, just know that person is a false prophet. Spirit of God will not tell you to go and commit adultery. Spirit of God will not tell you to go and steal. Spirit of God will not tell you not to forgive somebody. No matter what that person has done to you, you can still live and forgive. The moment you don't forgive, Satan will outwit you. That shows you give a place to the devil. And tell someone, don't give a place to the devil. Rise up on your feet.